By the end of this video, you will be able to write your very first Java code just like this. Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can download JDK and Eclipse IDE step by step. Just go online and type JDK download. The very first link which you see here is the official link of Oracle and it's completely safe to click. So just go ahead and click on this link. Now when you go down here, you will see that JDK 25 is the latest version, but I am going to download JDK 21. They both are the LTS versions. So just click on JDK 21. And go down a bit. Now here, if you are on Windows, you can click on Windows, and if you are on MacBook, you can click on MacBook, and if you are on this, you can click on this one. But I am on Windows, so I will click on Windows and I will choose this option. Why? Because this is easy and it will do everything automatically when I will download Eclipse IDE. So go ahead and click on this link. Your download will start. Now you have downloaded your JDK 21. Now the next step is just open your download folder and you will see that the JDK 21 is here. Okay. Now what you have to do is just double click on this JDK 21. And here you have to choose next. And if you want to change your folder path, which means where your JDK 21 will store, so you can change from here, but I don't want to change, so I will go for next. And it will start your installation. Now, as you can see, JDK 21 is successfully installed, so you can just go here and close. And if you want to see that whether the Java is successfully installed in your computer, then you can open command prompt and you can type here java-version and hit enter. As you can see that Java version 21 is installed in your system. Congratulations. Now what you have to do again, just go online and type Eclipse download. Okay. So the very first link which you see here is the official link and it's again completely safe and okay. So just go ahead and click on this. Now here you have to choose download and download x86, so click on x86. And the one last step is just click on this download button and it will start your downloading. Now my download is complete here. Now I will go again to my download folder and as you can see that Eclipse IDE is already here, so just go ahead and double click on this. Now maybe it will take a bit of time on your PC, so don't panic. Now here what to choose is very, very important guys, because see, if you want to do only core Java, you can click on this, and if you want to do like advanced Java things, then you have to click on this one. And for C language or C++, you can click on this. But I want this one because I'm going to make videos on core Java first, then I will do advanced Java. So I will choose this one for core Java things. Okay, so just go ahead and click on this. And install button is here, so you can click on this and it will start your installation. And again, it will take a bit of time, so don't panic here. Now one more thing is very important, that you have to accept the license, so just click on accept button. Now everything is complete, so click on launch. Now again guys, here it's very important, Eclipse says by default I will save your code in this folder, so if you want to change, you can go here and you can change your path as well, but I don't want to change. And if you do not want to change, then you can click on launch here, and it will start your Eclipse IDE. Now guys, I will choose here this option because I have downloaded this IDE from the official website, so I don't need this this option. So I will go with this option. So just click on proceed. Now our Eclipse is ready and set to go. Now the very first thing here, I will go to Windows and I will go this option. I will click on this, and you can go here and type JREs. JREs here, and you can click on installer JREs. And as you can see here that by default Eclipse has already, you know, found your JDK 21. And in case guys, if your JDK is not here, so what you can do here, you can go to add and you can click on standard VM, click next here and go to your dictionary folder and choose where your Java is present. So in my case, it's in local disk C, and it's in program files. Click J, which is Java here, and now click Java. Now you will see your JDK 21 is here. So just click on this folder and select that folder and click here, finish. Now see, JDK 21 is here, and click apply and apply and close. Now everything is set to go, and we have to do one more thing, which is Java project. So I will go here and choose a new and choose here Java project, or you can also go here and click create a Java and put a name here, like something name, like you can choose here my course 2025, and you can choose here JRE, which I have downloaded, which is JDK 21. So click on JRE 21 and finish. Now the next part is just click on this arrow, or you can double click on this, and on SRC, don't click on this one, you have to click on SRC. Just right click on SRC and go here new again, click you have to first create one package, and I will choose the name of package, which is P1 here, and click finish. Now you have to click on P1, right? Just right click on P1 and go here and choose one class. Now choose your name, what you want to choose, it's up to you. So I want to choose A and click here, finish. And one more thing, the name should be and must be in upper case. If you give it as a lower case, it will not work. It's saying that by convention, Java names start with an uppercase. So I will type here uppercase A and I will finish. Now, as you can see here, my class is here. Now I need one main method, guys. Now I will type here public static void main string args. And I will write some code here, which is welcome to Java, and you have to save this file, right? Otherwise it will not run. So in your Eclipse IDE, you can use Control plus S to save the file. And now I want to run this code, so just go ahead and click this button, which is here. Just click on this. Now as you can see, my output is here, welcome to Java. And now guys, you have finally wrote your first Java code. So very congratulations. And that's it for this video guys. You just ran your very first Java code. And if you found this helpful, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. And guys, don't forget to hit the bell icon so you do not miss my upcoming Java series. Thank you.